An evolutionary point of view, or things leading toward self-organization, so then I began to develop the idea, hey, wait a minute, there is an evolution going on of the development of fine motor skills, the replication of attitudes of action, and doing it with voluntary movement. And that then was the birth of understanding, or trying to understand the relationship between involuntary acts and voluntary acts, how they were linked. And then that opened the whole door to cortical evolution. Mm-hmm. And when did the cortical explosion start, which can be given a time frame? A time frame within modern history. Mm-hmm. So going back as far as we've been able to unearth archaeological events, so we can see the change in the brain pan, we can see the change of the upright posture, and then we see the change in tool making, and then we see the change in making images. And all of a sudden you have a time frame. You're going back 50, 80,000 years, 60,000 years, 40,000 years. But it's more than the evolution of the nervous system, it's the evolution of the entire organism. Mm-hmm. It's not simply how the brain controls the body. It is how the brain is part of the body that has learned and is learning to differentiate itself through the organ that it has brought on the scene, which is the cortex. Mm-hmm. So then I saw that voluntary effort was in fact a evolutionary event that took over from two stages before. There was the chemical evolutionary event in the body, how chemicals produce in the organism change behavior, like the thyroid, mm-hmm. like the adrenal cortex, mm-hmm. and so forth, and then how the nervous system began to enter the scene. And then how involuntary self-regulation, automatic self-regulation, changed to voluntary regulation. Mm-hmm. How an organism, instead of migrating in bad weather, made shelter for themselves. Mm-hmm. Instead of following the seasonal crop, they learned how to store food. I mean, so there's mm-hmm. a whole development that's still going on. And that then changes the formula for what is the dilemmas that people find themselves in this switch from automatic self-regulation, involuntary self-regulation, to voluntary self-regulation, which then tells you about the body and its cortex, mm-hmm. which I refer to in my languaging as the body in the brain, mm-hmm. the brain centers of the body, and then how the cortex makes images and influence and becomes the brain or the cortex in the body. Mm-hmm. And you have this dialogue, which really is the foundation of helping people begin to understand how to influence their life. Mm-hmm. That dialogue. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You have to introduce voluntary effort as a sequence of muscular steps in order to access and make a pathway to the higher organizing processes which come out of that process. So, how voluntary effort is applied and how you can sequence it.
Mm-hmm.
And that opened up an enormous vista which took me by surprise. Mm-hmm.